Hello, this is Professor Sampson, and today we're going to be working on factors. Now, if you looked at the video, you can find factors by hand, but we're going to work on finding factors in the calculator to speed you up. A factor is a number that is multiplied by another number to get to the number in question. So, for example, if you had 8 and you wanted to find the factors of 8, you would list, well, 1 times 8, and I'm going to try and spread them apart, 2 times 4, and then you would go to 3, but 3 doesn't divide it evenly, okay? So if I wanted to list the factors of 6, I would do the same thing. I would start with 1 and 6, then the next number would be 2 to see if 2 went into it, and it does. It goes into it 3 times, and then I have 3 already. So yeah, I could do this, and this would be fine, but as I get to larger numbers, I get more factors. So if I wanted to list the factors of 24, I got 1 and 24, which I'm putting over there. Then I go to the next one, 2. And then I say, does 2 go in a 24? Yes. 2 goes in a 24 12 times. Then I say, does 3 go into 24? And then I say, yes, 3 goes in a 24 8 times. Then I say, does 4 go in a 24? And then I say, yes, 4 goes into 24 6 times. Then I say, does 5 go into 24? And then I say, no, and then I'm back at 6. I say no because it doesn't go in evenly. But if you have larger and larger numbers, do you want to be listing those like that, especially when you have the calculator? So what we're going to do is list the factors using our calculator. So let's say if I wanted to, again, list the factors of 24 in my calculator. So what I would have to do, and I'm going to clear this out, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the Y equals key, which is right here in the upper left-hand corner. So I'm going to hit Y equals. And just follow the keystrokes. And then in here, I'm going to put my number, whatever that number is, in this case is 24, and I'm going to divide it by X. And to get X, I need to hit the X, T, theta button, which is right here under mode. Alright, so I'm going to put 24 divided by, again, that X, T, theta button, which is X, and that's going to give me X. So I hit enter. Alright, then I need to list the factors, so I need a table. Right? So to go to the table, I'm going to hit second, because I'm going to get to the table. If you look right on top of, if I can readjust this, if you look right on top of that graph key, right, you'll see table. So I need to hit second, then I hit table, or I hit graph actually, and graph takes me to the table at top if I hit the second button. And there are my factors. Of course, you start with 0, 1 and 24, 2 and 12, 3 and 8, 4 and 6, 5 doesn't go, and then I'm back to 6 and 4, which I already have. So that's a much faster way to list the factors, because my numbers can get larger and larger. So let's say if I wanted to find the greatest factor that two separate numbers have in common. So if I wanted to do 24 and 15. Now I already listed all the factors of 24. Let's say if I wanted to then list the factors of 15. I would have 1 and 15. It doesn't go into 2, but it does go into 3, and it doesn't go into 4. So I got 1 times 15 and 3 times 5. Then I have 24, which had all these numbers that I'm just going to copy down. 24 had 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. Well, if I want to find out what's the greatest, I can find out what the common factors are. I have a common factor of 1. I have a common factor of 3. That's all the common factors that I have. But what we usually look for is what we call the GCF, or the greatest common factor. All right. So the greatest common factor is the greatest number that both of those numbers have in common. Alright, so 15 and 24, we can see that the GCF is 3. It's the greatest number they both have in common. Again, this, we have a calculator, so we don't want to do this in the by hand. We don't want to list these in circle, because we could have bigger numbers. So to find the GCF in the calculator, you're going to hit the math button, which is right under the alpha key, three down. You're going to go over. You have to hit the over button to go over to num. And then you can just scroll down here, and you see GCD, which is the same thing as GCF. All right, right there, number 9. So you're going to hit number 9. All right. Once you do that, let me get out of here first. All right. So we did math, we went over the number, and then we hit number 9. You're going to get this. And you're going to plug in the numbers, but you have to use a comma between the numbers. So I'm going to plug in the two numbers here, 15, comma, 24. Close my parentheses, and it's going to give me back 3. Much easier than trying to keep listing the factors. It's faster, and you can use numbers like if you wanted to find a GCF of 132 and 198. Try that now. You would have math, and you would go over the number. You would hit number 9, and you would put in 132, comma, 198. Close the parenthesis, and that answer 66. So again, this is much faster because you don't want to be listing all of these factors all the way up past 66. You have to go to 1 times 132. Okay. So what we did today was we found the factors of a number. We learned how to find the factors of a number. Just if it's an individual number and they say find the factors of a number. We also figured out how do we look in our calculator and find the GCF, the greatest common factor. We used a button that says a GCD. So that'll take care of that section.